Each week, American History TV's American Artifacts takes you to museums and historic places. Opened in 1909, the Russell Center Office Building was constructed to relieve crowded conditions in the U.S. Capitol. In the first of a two-part program, we'll learn about the history of the building and the many notable Senate investigations held in the historic caucus room, from 1912's Titanic inquiry to 1930s hearings about the causes of the 1929 stock market crash and subsequent financial reforms.
I'm Don Ritchie, the Senate historian, and we're in the Senate Caucus Room, which is in the Russell Senate Office Building. Before C-SPAN started covering the Senate in 1986, this was the most famous room in the Capitol and in the Capitol complex, because this is where the major hearings had been televised, going back to the, newsreels covered it back in the 1920s and 30s. J.P. Morgan Jr. testified in this room. And that, of course, got a huge amount of attention because J.P. Morgan was a very private banker. No bank examiner had ever gone into the Morgan Bank at that point. And it was here, and it was in May of 1933, at the beginning of May, that, that Morgan was testifying. Barnum and Bailey Circus happened to be in Washington then. And a circus promoter brought along a little person who identified herself as a circus midget. And during a break, the senators withdrew to the back room to talk something over. Morgan was sitting at the witness stand, and the circus promoter dropped the midget into Morgan's lap, and he thought it was a little girl at first. And he said, "I have a granddaughter who's bigger than you." And she said, "Yes, but I'm older." And then he realized that it wasn't a little girl, and he quickly dropped her out of his lap, but every press photographer had a picture of it. And the committee came back, they were really chagrined about this, and they asked the press not to print this picture. Of course, it was on the front page of pretty much every newspaper the next day. And it was a symbolic picture of these once Olympian bankers being humbled by what was going on in Congress.